Hello, I'm going to be reacting to another Zorgan Ziari clips. So the guest here is Matthew Walker. So he's the sleep expert here. He's the professor at neuropsychology. The title here is about sleep expert on insomnia. Insomnia is something like inability to sleep during night, right? All right, let's check out.
What should someone do if they have a hard time sleeping? Like, say if you're a person who has insomnia, you have a hard time getting to bed, you have a hard time staying asleep. When you wake up, you can't go back to bed.
Yeah.
Are there strategies?
Yeah, I used to have insomnia when I'm very ill.
There are. I mean, I think for most people, there are five things that you can do just out the gate to get better sleep. Regularity is probably the most important thing I can tell you. Go to bed at the same time, wake up at the same time, no matter whether it's the weekend, weekday. Regularity is key.
So I guess I'm pretty regular. Let's continue the video.
We've spoken about light. For example, when you, in the last hour before bed, try to stay away from screens, but also just switch off half the lights in the house. You would be surprised at how soporific that is. It really starts to sort of make you feel a bit more
drowsy. That's true, though.
They've done some great studies where they would take people out, you know, into the...
But I haven't been able to stay away from my phone, especially before I sleep.
Rockies. No electric light, no electricity whatsoever. And they started to go to bed 2 hours earlier than their acclaimed natural bedtime.
Okay.
It wasn't just because they didn't have anything necessarily to do. It was that their melatonin was rising, you know, 2 hours earlier. So keep it dark. The third is probably keep it cool. Your brain actually needs to drop its temperature by about 2 to 3 degrees Fahrenheit to initiate sleep.
That makes sense.
The reason that you will always find it easier to fall asleep in a room that's too cold than too hot.
I've seen people use cold pads.
Yeah.
Have you seen those? You sleep on these cold pads. What do you think of those?
Cold pads.
The evidence is pretty good that cooling the body actually works. They've, in the book I write about a series of studies where they had people in, it's almost like a wetsuit, but it has all of these veins running through it. And they could actually perfuse warm or cold water into any part of the body, hands, core of the body, feet. And so that you could exquisitely manipulate the temperature of any part
of the body. That's
pretty cool. And what they found is that they could effectively cool the body down, and it instantaneously made people fall asleep faster, and it gave them deeper, deep non-REM sleep, that sort of restorative sleep for the body. So, and you can even look at studies where people sleep semi-naked, and that also seems to improve their sleep, and they get a little bit more deep sleep too.
Okay.
So cold is better. The paradox here, though, is that you need to warm your feet and your hands to kind of charm the blood away from your core out to the surface and radiate that heat.
Really? So you should go to sleep with socks and gloves on?
Yeah. Or better still, have a hot bath.
I didn't know you could fall asleep quickly with socks and gloves on. That's very interesting.
Evidence here too that I discuss where people say, you know, I get out of a hot bath, I feel nice and toasty, I'm relaxed, and that's why I fall asleep. It's the opposite. When you get into a bath, you get vasodilation. You sort of get rosy cheeks, red skin. All of the blood rushes to the surface. You get out of the bath, and you have this massive thermal dump of heat that just evacuates from the body. Your core body temperature plummets, and that's why you sleep better. So you can hack the system very easily.
Wow. So your core body temperature plummets, and that's what makes you sleep easier.
Yeah.
That sounds so counterintuitive.
Yeah.
But it makes sense.
And it makes sense because that's how we were designed. If you look at hunter-gatherer tribes whose way of life has not changed for thousands of years and you ask how do they sleep, one of the things that seems to dictate their sleep is the rise and fall of temperature. You know, temperature is at its lowest in the nadir of the night, you know, 3 or 4 in the morning. And as that temperature, that climate temperature starts to drop, that's when they start to get drowsy. As if temperature is just sort of signaling to the brain, now it's time to sleep.
That makes sense.
So light as well as temperature are two key triggers to help you get better sleep.
So the light and the temperature affects the sleep. That's some pretty cool information.
If you look at those tribes, by the way, and when they go to sleep and they wake up, you know, they go to sleep probably at 2 hours after dusk, sort of 8 to 9 in the evening, wake up about half an hour, even an hour before dawn. It's the rise in temperature rather than light that triggers their awakening.
Wow.
But there's a reason, you know. Have you ever thought about what the term midnight actually means? Middle of the night.
Right.
And that's what it should be for all of us. But in modernity, we've been dislocated from our natural rhythms. And now midnight has become the time when we think, I should check Facebook last time. You know, I should, you know, send my last email.
Yeah.
That wasn't, that is not how we were, you know, designed.
That's not what we should actually do.
Sleep. And in fact, we may also be designed to sleep biphasically too. If you look at those hunter-gatherers, they don't sleep one long bout of 8 hours at night.
Yeah, I've heard this recently, that people, that you should have two sleeps. The idea of two sleeps.
Yeah, it's actually a little different than the idea of two sleeps. So there was a time in sort of the Dickensian era where people would sleep for the first half of the night, maybe sort of 4 hours or so. Then they would wake up, they would socialize, they would eat, they would make love, and then they would go back and have a second sleep.
I don't think I've ever had to sleep.
If you look at natural biological rhythms in the brain and the
body, I mean, too long sleep.
Body, that doesn't really seem to be how we were designed. It certainly seems to be something that we did in society, but I think it's more of a societal trend than it was a biological edict. However, we do seem to have two sleep periods the way that we were designed. Those tribes will often sleep about 6.5 hours, 7 hours of sleep at night. And then especially in the summer, they'll have that siesta-like behavior in the afternoon. And all of us have that. Sort of this, what's called the postprandial dip in alertness, just means after lunch. And if I measure your brainwave activity with electrodes, I can see a drop in your physiological alertness somewhere between 2 to 4 p.m. in the afternoon.
But is that dependent on diet?
It's not. People think it is, you know, especially after they've had a heavy lunch.
Yeah.
You can actually just have people fast and sort of, fasting for long periods of time actually makes your sleep much worse. But you can have people abstain from lunch and you still get that drop. So it's independent of food. It's a genetically hardwired pre-programmed drop that suggests we should be sleeping biphasically.
But is that dependent upon their standard diet? Because if someone is on a carbohydrate-rich diet, a lot of times you do get that spike and then you crash. But when people are on low-carb and high-fat diets, they don't get that. And they tend to be more even with their energy through the day.
Yeah. So yeah, that sort of more constant release of energy can actually help you sort of almost combat that lull.
But that lull exists no matter what.
Exactly.
So even if you don't think it exists, it's there.
It's still present.
Interesting.
Yeah.
So why did they do that in the Dickens era? Why did they, what is there a root cause of their double sleep thing?
We don't know. I mean, it's hard to sort of really go back.
Fascinating.
There's, yeah, it's
incredible. That was a trend.
Yeah, that it was a movement.
That they would just wake up and do things and.
Yeah.
Maybe it's because they didn't have TV. And they didn't know what to do with themselves.
Yeah. Well, sounds like they did some pretty interesting things, which were nice. But
that was a really good video. I really enjoyed it. That was very informative as well. I haven't had insomnia for the last years, except for when I was sick. That's pretty good, I guess. Maybe I should try out that 2 pairs of sleep. 4 hours sleep during afternoon and 4 hours sleep in the midnight. Also, let me know down in the comments what other videos would you like me to react to next. If you want to check out all my recommended equipment in the video, check out the playlist next below, which I guess will commission, but no extra cost to you. Also, don't hesitate to comment what you thought about this video. Make sure you subscribe so this channel gets more subscribers. Like the video to help out YouTube to recommend this video to many people around the world and share this video with your friends, family, and relatives. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.